Today, I want to share with you the simplest way to manage your budget without the use of fancy spreadsheets or expensive planners. So I'm really excited to share this with y'all. I have been using this cheap budgeting tool for the past few years, and it's helped me be able to keep track of our finances so much easier than the previous way that I was using. I used to always write out our budget on a piece of notebook paper, and I would, you know, do it every single payday, and I would calculate everything, but it went on the piece of paper, and then the piece of paper would get lost. The kids would start using it as artwork and they would draw on it. And so I found this other tool that I started using a few years ago, and it is awesome. So this is called a home finance and bill organizer. And this thing is amazing. It is $3 at your Dollar General. They also sell a version of this at the Dollar Tree, but it's not as good of quality. So it's worth it paying an extra $2 for this planner. So the home finance and bill organizer is set up. In the front, you have the planning calendars that tell you the whole year of dates. You can go in and circle certain dates if you need to. But the biggest feature that I love about this is, one, it's made with cardboard, just like an expensive fancy planner would be, and they have pockets inside of it. So let's say that you get a bill in the mail, you open it up immediately for January, starting next month, I'll open my bills and I will place them inside the folder until it's payday and it's time to pay bills. So this planner, if you can see, has two columns, one here and one here. And if you can fit them all on the two different columns, what I do is we get paid every 2 weeks, or my husband does. So we put our take-home pay up here at the top and our take-home pay for the second paycheck of the month over here. And it's got due date, expenses, the amount, and a little spot for you to put a check mark when you've paid it. So what I do is I gather up all the bills throughout the month as they're coming in, and before payday comes, I'll sit down and I'll calculate, here's our take-home income, this is what's due the first paycheck of the month, this is what's getting paid the first paycheck of the month, and then at the bottom, I draw a line, I subtract everything, and whatever is left is either getting put towards savings or it's going towards our debt snowball. Now, this is gonna be a series of videos where I talk about budgeting and the debt snowball versus the debt avalanche. So definitely subscribe to the channel so that you get those updates, and push the bell notification icon so that you don't miss those, because you're not notified automatically. You have to hit the bell icon next to the subscribe. So anyways, this is it. You just simply put your take-home pay, you subtract all of your bills, and then at the bottom, you're going to have hopefully a little bit of money left over that you can put towards either paying off debt or savings, or a little bit of both if that's your plan. So again, I'm gonna talk a little bit more about detailed debt payoff plans in the next couple of videos. So be sure to subscribe, and I hope you have an awesome day. I'll see you in the next one.